Beyond the direct cost of cancelling flights to China, needing to refund clients, not getting revenue from that, what are the other concrete business decisions that get impacted by these stoppages in terms of fuel, you know, buying and so on?
No, clearly the biggest decision we have to take, and we follow that on a day-to-day basis, is a decision concerning the network and the flight to China. For that, we are in contact permanently with operations internally, but also with people on the other side in China. We try to evaluate as precisely as possible the situation, but the main decision for us is when will it be possible to resume the flights to China. For the time being, we expect not to resume the flight in between now and the end of February. It's probably not in March, but we have to reevaluate the situation on a daily basis to see if, for example, it will be possible to fly again to China by the end of March or the beginning of April, which is today our scenario, but of course to be reevaluated on a permanent basis.
Monsieur Gaget, how will you make that decision? Will it depend on when other airlines begin to fly again? Will it depend on the rate of slowing of deaths, for example? How do you make a decision like that?
It is clearly our own approach. We discuss with the people, specialists in health, of course, with doctors. We have internal doctors. We speak to Chinese authority also. And this is based on, again, all these ingredients that we can take the decision to resume flight. What is the most important? The most important, we have to be sure that we are providing safety and security for the client and for the crews. You cannot say, okay, I fly, I don't know what will happen, but I continue to fly or I resume flying because it will be good. Clearly, the first element to be taken into consideration is the security and the safety of our passengers and of our crews. After that, there is, of course, the analysis of the economics of the crisis. Is the demand coming up? Is there a demand for this flight? And it is based on these various ingredients, again, that we can take a decision.
Mr. Gaget, you say you're reviewing the decision on a day-by-day basis. What is happening to the wide bodies that are no longer being deployed on these legs? Are you able to return them to lessors, or what are you doing with them?
No, clearly, for the time being, we are dealing the short term of the crisis. So what we do with the aircraft which are not flying anymore to China, they are grounded. We use the current period and the availability of these aircraft to make some maintenance operation, so we can anticipate operation or organize repairs which can be planned a bit later, but we do it now because these aircraft are available. And we are doing as our other colleagues. For example, this morning you have seen the announcement of Lufthansa telling to the market that they are grounded, of course, some aircraft, and it is the case for KLM, and it is the case for Air France also. So these aircraft are available. For the time being, it's mainly for maintenance operation. We try to anticipate it. And we are also planning the possibility to reorganize the network in order to use these available aircraft to some different routes out of China, as for the time being, they are not flying to China. So there is this aircraft available, and we see if there is some possibility to redeploy this capacity to some other markets.
Chinese tourists make up quite a big part of the summer operation in Europe. There are thousands and thousands of Chinese tourists flying around Europe every day during the summer. Do you think there will be a secondary hit into the short-haul network as a result of these Chinese tourists not being in Europe this summer?
First, you have to wait what is the next step in the current crisis. And I have not said to you that it will be necessary up to the summer. But suppose that it is a bit longer. Yes, clearly, it will also impact the short-haul operations, because a lot of these Chinese we welcome in Europe for tourism and during the holidays in summer are also flying short-haul flights in order to visit various countries into Europe. So it will have also an impact on the short-haul during the summer if the crisis was as long as that, what clearly we are not wishing. We expect all that, both for the Chinese population, which are first impacted, of course, but also for the companies, that the crisis will be as short as possible. But yes, if it is longer, there will be an impact also on the medium haul.
Mr. Gatti, your CEO Ben Smith has said you're not looking at another airline, Alitalia, for example, but you know, maybe not Alitalia. Is there another airline or, you know, joint venture or anything that might make sense for Air France KLM?
Yeah, I think that 2 years ago we made a very important step with the integration of Virgin Atlantic into the JV, the joint venture we have with Delta. And this new joint venture has been put in place beginning of this year, 2020, and I think it is a new step towards the consolidation in Europe. And of course, we continue to look on the European market if there is some case of possible M&A deals which could be of interest for Air France KLM. But again, we do that by also keeping a strict view on our financial discipline.
All right, we have to
and
leave it
there. And for Alitalia, specific case, Ben Smith gave this morning a very clear answer concerning Alitalia.